When we first started looking after very advanced stage cancer patients, our entire focus was on their medical condition. As time went on and as we started more and more patient care, we realized that, of course, the medical part of the care was most important, but there was another aspect which at that stage of life was perhaps equally important or even more important to the patient and to his family. And that was his psychological, his mental well-being at that stage of life. We've had a patient where a father became a totally unforgiving human being and he put his only daughter out of his mind, all because she got married to somebody who he had not approved of. For 25 years he lived in that state, the daughter suffering in her own right, the father being absolutely hard and unforgiving, but at the end of life he wanted a reconciliation, which we agreed and arranged. And that reconciliation and that forgiveness on both sides was the state in which he breathed his last. These are the emotions, these are the feelings that get accentuated during the advanced stages of the disease. Why we said this was there is perhaps even more need for help for a patient and for the patient's family when you're addressing their psychological needs. Each of these people have gone through a lot in life. They've had a lot of emotions, a lot of experiences, and a lot of exchange with other human beings. And all of that has got imprinted into their way of thinking. We've looked after about 25,000 patients so far. And believe me when I tell you, we've got about 25,000 different stories to tell. And this was one of the things that we were feeling for a long time, that we had this wealth of human emotion that was with us, but we had not recorded it, or not recorded it for others to see. We finally got down to it and have put this in the form of a book. Out of all the stories that we had to tell, we chose some 30 or 35, and each of them is a gem in itself. All this has gone into one book. All this has gone into one book which can benefit a whole lot of people. It can affect those people who are going into palliative care, either as a professional doctor or a nurse, or anybody who's interested in the subject of human interaction. I would recommend people reading this not only as stories, but as part of education. Let me tell you that even after 25,000 patients and 25,000 families, we are still learning. There's a lot more for us to learn, and that we have tried to put down in one small volume that is bound to benefit anybody who reads it.